Pigeonhole. Today is June 27th, 1806. On this day, in the town of Madurai, India,
the world changed.
Augustus DeMorgan, a brilliant mathematician, saw the light of day. His father was Colonel DeMorgan, a British man stationed in India. His father and grandfather were born in India as well. His mother is a descendant of the mathematician named James Dodson.
After 7 months of infancy in India, Colonel DeMorgan and his family packed their bags and moved to England. Due to this mixed heritage, Augustus used to say that he was neither English, nor Scottish, nor Irish, but a Briton unattached.
Tragically, at the age of 10, young DeMorgan's father passed away. The now widowed Mrs. DeMorgan began moving across southwest England. Because of this, Augustus attended many different elementary schools, resulting in a late surfacing of his mathematical talents.
However, at the age of 14, DeMorgan was discovered drawing an elaborate figure in geometry. After receiving a secondary education that ironically did not focus on mathematics, DeMorgan began showing the attitude of a rebellious teenager in the form of his discontent with the Church of England, and with organized religion in general. This created tension between him and his mother, a devout follower.
In 1823, at the age of 16, DeMorgan attended Trinity College, Cambridge. That's right, 16. Here, his teachers and later good friends included George Peacock and William Hewell. While attending this college, he played the flute in his spare time and opted not to participate in sports. He placed fourth in his class academically.
After his education was complete, he became a math professor at London University and contributed to various works in addition to writing his own. He and his son George founded the London Mathematical Society, which still exists today. Unfortunately, he died on March 18, 1871.
DeMorgan was among the first mathematicians to coin the term and thoroughly examine the principles of mathematical induction. Here is a brief explanation using real-world application. Sort of.
So, let's assume that k plus 1 is this step right here. So, if we can get to k plus 1, we can then assume that we can get to the rest of the steps to prove that a statement is true. So, here's k plus 1, k plus 2, all the way up to n, which would then prove that our statement is true.
Look, we're doing induction! Look, more induction! Look, more induction. Yeah, but you're climbing up really slow, so it's like weak induction.
This is automated induction.
Watch the lights go down. See? Right there? That's quick induction. People don't know about that yet.
And in the event of a fire, we must resort to regular induction.
Sadly.
With DeMorgan's laws, we can prove that the following, A and B, not, is equivalent to A, not, or B, not. Cool. We'll be right back.
heard that boogie rhythm. Hey, I had no choice but to get down, 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 dance. Woo. Nothing left for me to do but dance. All these bad times I'm going through, just dance. Got candy in my ears tonight, big bet. Woo. I feel the thunder, see the lightning. I know this anger's heaven sent.
So, practical application of DeMorgan's laws in the field of circuits and CSC 120 is, if you have an AND gate with two inputs and the result of that is not if, which is, I believe it's a NAND gate, right? Okay, yeah, it's a NAND gate. That is equivalent to an OR gate with not even inputs. So essentially this is saying that the quantity of A and B not is equivalent to A not or B not. And that is DeMorgan's law.
Alright, so I'm here with Karen Sow. I have a couple questions for her regarding DeMorgan. First question I'd like to ask you is, what would you ask Augustus DeMorgan if he was alive today?
I would ask him where he came up with the idea to start talking about the complex of sense.
Great answer.
Okay.
Another question for you is, how has DeMorgan affected the curriculum for our class?
So the main things that he did for our class were talking about the complex of sense and medians and intersections, and also he was kind of the first person to really discuss induction in depth.
Thank you very much for your time.
You're welcome.
Have a wonderful day.
Thanks. This is Discrete Math, teacher approved.
All of these pigeons have a hole, but one.
That's so-